Hi everyone, thanks for joining me. I'm Juliana with the Zakim Center, and this is Chair Yoga Flow. So we're going to be moving on our chair, seated on the chair most of the time. And right now we're going to start actually with the massaging the feet with a tennis ball or a massage ball. And we're going to use this to start, again, other props that we're going to be using today, a strap or a yoga belt or a tie, a scarf, a towel, and a couple of yoga blocks as well. So if you move to the back of your chair, have that as your support, drop the ball down to the foot, under the foot, and we're gonna start massaging here. So start pressing into the ball, going to your heel, and as you exhale, soften and come back to your toes. So start to bring awareness to the here and now as you press, you move, and as you exhale, you soften and bring it back. A couple more like that, inhaling, and exhaling, and then allowing the ball to stay on the ball of your foot, and perhaps you do a little flaring gripping with the toes, spreading it out, moving it a little side to side. Now throughout the practice, I'll give you some, you know, ideas to move, guide you through this, but if there's any spot that's calling your attention, if you want to change, modify, and if you don't know how to modify, you can always add, ask, and you put there on the chat, and I'll be happy to help you out if you don't know what to do. Again, just taking it at your own pace, what feels comfortable. Starting to move the ball a little bit more now to the arch, inner arch, outer arch. And just starting to notice the sensations here as you press. And I'm going to start to come closer to the heel. And the ball of my foot is going to be the anchor, so you can climb up a little bit higher and do a little kind of like side to side massage or pressing more. And then we're going to come out of this and just starting to notice the difference between the right and the left, maybe the arch dropping, feeling a little bit more supported here. And we're going to take the same thing on the other side. So again, firming yourself with the hand on the chair as you start to move back and forth. Sorry, I'm just trying to flip this microphone, which is too big for me, but moving it back and forth, starting to notice the sensations between the difference between one side and then the other, sensations beneath your feet, and start to notice awareness is part of the yoga practice, being present, mindful. I'm going to come to the ball of the foot and giving that little stretching, pressing, gripping, maybe flaring the toes with the ball, using that, maybe adding a little bit more pressure into that mound. Again, this side might feel very different than the other, but being mindful of that as well. And always moving with kindness, always curiosity, always room for exploration. And again, remember there's no right or wrong. What feels good, right? Everybody's different. Sides are different. And we're just going to move a little up. Take your time to come down. So this practice is really nice for neuropathy on the feet, arthritis, plantar fasciitis, releasing a lot of tension in the back. Not only the soles, but also the back of the legs and spine. We're going to start to move to the chair. And as you find your seat on your chair, make sure your feet are fully supported. So if your chair feels a little too high, you can put two blocks under your feet, or it could be a blanket or even a book. Just something that you can level off here. And just finding that grounding, the support. Let your hands rest onto your thighs. And start to take a nice deep breath through your nose and a big sigh through the mouth. Feel those shoulders ascending, the body relaxing. Inhale, filling up, and exhale, empty it out. So letting go of tension, of stress, of drama, anxiety. Take one more deep breath in. And a huge sigh, let it go. Perhaps closing your eyes if your eyes are not closed. Just allowing your body to settle in. Really feel connected to the here and now, noticing where your body is right now. It might start with the connection of the feet rooting into the earth, finding that support, that sense of safety, of belonging, of well-being that the earth provides you. And feeling that your sit bones are also connected deeply into your chair, allowing you to relax through your legs, all the way to your toes, and also allowing the spine to lengthen up. Feeling the head reaching up to the heavens, spine is nice and tall. And the muscles in your face start to soften as you start to relax the corners of the eyes, the cheeks, the jaw, even allowing your tongue to move, floating a little bit more, maybe even a movement of the jaw side to side. Maybe a yawn comes out of it. Continue to feel that release of the back of the throat, down the shoulders, the elbows, and fingertips. Resting on your thigh, supported. And the heart feels light, and the belly feels soft. You find your body fully supported, relaxed, and safe. In the stillness of the body, there's still movement of the breath. So starting to follow that movement of the breath. Perhaps even allowing one hand to rest in your belly. And feeling that belly breath, which is very soothing and calming to the nervous system. Inhaling, expanding. Noticing that short pause before you exhale and soften and release. That short pause before you take a new breath. So today, besides just bringing the awareness to the breath, we're going to actually start to control the breath, the pranayama, breath control. And so if the breath control doesn't work for you, you can always stay just focusing on that belly breath. We're going to do a Durga breath, a three-part breathing. So first, it's just that inhalation in and out in the belly. Just as you're doing the inhale, noticing that hold before you exhale, and noticing that pause before you take a new breath. Take your other hand to your ribs and inhale into the belly. Hold, inhale to your ribs, hold, and exhale all the way down. Feel the navel pulling into the spine, air moving out. Let's do that again. Inhale, belly, hold, ribs, hold, and exhale all the way down. Navel pulling in, the hand that's on the ribs moves up to your sternum, collarbones. Inhale into the belly. Hold, ribs, hold, lift it a little bit higher, all the way up, hold, exhale, top to bottom. Notice that pause, and inhale, belly, hold, ribs, hold, all the way up a little bit higher, hold, exhale, top to bottom. Navel pulling in, release your hands to your thighs, and just let the body, the breath feel fuller and deeper and smoother. Increasing that lung capacity, expanding it a little bit more. Noticing how the mind is quieter than when you started. So whenever you feel there's too much going on, you can always come back to the breath by noticing the breath as a type of mindfulness meditation, or by controlling the breath of pranayama to help you to find a little bit more calm, a little bit more pause between your thoughts. And in that pause, you can take that deeper breath. And in that pause, you can make better decisions, react better, and feel better. So when you feel ready, bringing one hand and then the other over your heart center and breathe into your heart the gratitude of being here today, of taking time to take care of yourself. Anything else that brings you joy and gratitude. And in this light in your heart, plant the seed of your intention. What is your heart's deepest longing? Let it settle in. Gently bowing your head to your heart, release your hands down. And when you feel ready, inhale, start to roll the heads of the shoulders up and back. Lift the head, blink your eyes open. And from here, we're going to move a little bit more to the center of the chair. You can perhaps take maybe now the blocks from beneath your feet, because now maybe your feet find that full support. And just bringing that block between, one of the blocks between your legs. And again, if you don't have a block, it'd be a t-shirt or a pillow. Just something that you can find a little bit more engagement of the feet and the engagement of the core as you gently squeeze and find the lifting of the spine. As you inhale, roll the heads of the shoulders up and back. Inhaling. And exhaling. Take one more like this. And we're going to start to add a little bit more range of motion. Fingertips to the shoulders. And you start to let your elbows go up, side, and then down. So starting to find a little bit more range. Going any formal way that works here for you. One side might feel different than the other, and that's okay. Just noticing, honoring it. And then with your next exhale, release your hands down. Drop your chin into your chest. And as you inhale, start to roll the left ear to the left shoulder. And as you exhale, roll the chin into the chest and start to roll the right ear to the right shoulder. Now, can you imagine you're making a little smiley face with the tip of your nose? So you're creating that half circle with the tip of your nose here from one side to the other. Not skipping any parts. And then next time your left ear is to your left shoulder, hold it there. And from this inhale, start to take your right arm out, maybe shoulder height, maybe even a little bit lower. Turn that right palm up. And as you exhale, you pull it in closer to your waist. Inhale, reach it out. And exhale, pull it closer to your waist. Your head is still hanging to the left. And then when you take it out, hold it here. Play with the angle of the head, looking down, side, and diagonally up to the right. And now start to play with the angle of the arm. Maybe the thumb will turn down, palm back, and then you start to lower the arm. Adding movement, continue adding movement with the neck, the arm. Again, you can combine both or just do one or the other. And when that arm comes down, you're going to roll your chin into your chest and take it to the other side. And from here, we pause, and maybe you're playing with the angle, looking down to your right fingertips and diagonally up. Just to start to notice that release to the side. And just holding that ear to the shoulder, inhale, take your left arm out, turn your left palm up. And as you exhale, bend that elbow, bring it to your waist, like you're carrying a tray on your hand, and then take it back out again. Exhale, bring it in. Keep the head hanging. Inhale, reach it out. Now just staying here. And again, you can play with the angle of the arm, turning it upside and down as you start to lower that arm. And you can add also the movement of the neck, keeping the shoulders relaxed, slow and controlled, let it bring it down, changing the angle, you're changing different muscles, different layers of muscles to stretch here. And as you exhale, roll your chin into your chest. And when you feel ready, press into your feet and inhale, let your arms start to come up, reach up, lift up. And as you exhale, you're going to turn your palms out like you're pushing through thick air, bring it down. Once again, firm through your feet, inhale, reach up, lift up, wherever up is for you. And exhale, palms push down like you're pushing through thick air, really controlling it. And maybe today actually feels like thick air outside, right? So hot and muggy. And then take your arms all the way up. You're going to bring your palms together in front of your heart. And we're going to pause here. Allow your fingers to lock, and it's soft lock, so you can just push and pump your arms out. And at the same time, you're getting a little stretch onto your back there, upper back, as you pump it out. Start to look over one shoulder and then the other. And then we're going to continue to pump the arms up. And as it starts to go up, it also helps with that lymphatic drainage of the arms, your immune system. And you start to reach it up. So firm to your feet and to your hips. And start to add that little side to side. Again, the elbows can be more bent or they can be more extended. Eventually, we're going to all release the fingers. Left hand comes to the chair, right arm goes up and over. Now imagine like you're brushing rainbows to the tips of your fingers up and over into the sky above you. But really kind of take your time to paint the ceiling here. Next time your left hand's on the chair, right arm is up, you're going to hold it there and just playing with the shoulders once again. It could just be the shoulders, it could be the elbow. It can even start to loosen it up a little bit more, working a little bit more with the side body this week. Really feeling that opening. Hand is going to come perhaps behind your head, and you're going to dial that elbow up, lift the chest, and open even deeper. Good job. Now from here, you're going to push into the seat and let both arms come up, and we're going to twist to the right. Inhale, lift to the crown of the head. Start to feel the spine getting nice and tall. And as you exhale, revolve that right shoulder slightly back. The hands might even slide a little further back. Inhale, lift, keep the length, engage the core. Exhale, perhaps you go a little deeper. The last part of the twist is the cervical spine, the neck. Maybe it looks back. Inhale, take both arms up to the sky. Reach up, lift up. And as you exhale, it's the right hand that comes to the chair, left arm up and over. So we're going to do one more like this. Beautiful. And next time that right hand comes to the chair, you're going to stay with the right hand on the chair. Left arm stays up. And again, you start to play here, shoulder, elbow, or loosening up the hand. Again, you can add as much movement as you want or less, just focusing. Let that hand come behind your head once again. And inhale, lift the chest, sternum, side body, armpits, like kidneys, your batteries here, charging them up, energizing. Dial that left elbow back like you're admiring a beautiful bird up on the tree. And as you exhale, push. Inhale, release your arms, let them land. Inhale, find a lift of the spine. As you exhale, perhaps you go a little deeper and you start to walk your hands further back. Inhale, lift. Exhale, maybe you walk a little further back. Last part of the twist, maybe it will be that neck if it feels okay to look back. Inhale, take both arms up to the sky, reach up, lift up. And as you exhale, we're going to cactus the arms. So starting to engage those back muscles. Inhale, engaging the shoulders. Exhale, almost like you're pulling a bungee cord, engaging those backs. Take one more. Nice. Now holding it, maybe the elbows a little bit lower. Think about tapping the back of your hands into an invisible wall behind you. And you feel that you start to engage more for three, for two. So you're not arching the back. It's just the hands. As you exhale, let your elbows come closer to your waist. And it's like you're carrying a tray here or two trays and your arms are just sliding on an invisible table. You're not letting your hands drop. You're engaged in the backs of the shoulders, rotator cuff, shoulder blades as well. Engage, looking like you're cracking a little walnut back there. And then you turn your palms to face each other, like you're gonna clap. Slightly different movement, slightly different origin of the muscle. And then from here, we're gonna take the arms all the way back up again. Find a deep inhale with the heart. And as you exhale, you're going to close your elbows. As you inhale, you're going to open. Now, as we exhale, we're going to tip it over to the right. Inhale, center. Exhale, let's close. Inhale, open. Now, exhale, let's tip it to the left. Inhale, center. Exhale, close. Inhale, center. Tip it to the right. Do that one more time. Inhale, center. Exhale, close. Inhale, center, exhale, tip it to the left. Now we're gonna stay back onto the center. Bring those elbows a little together, closer, closer, closer. Maybe they would be like magnets, they even glue together. Elbows go up, elbows go to one side, gaze to the opposite, and then to the other side. Beautiful, take your elbows up, reach up, And exhale, slowly release your wrists. Bring it all the way down to your thighs. Let's cat-cow the spine, hands on the thighs. Inhale, start to pull your chest forward and through as you pull your elbows back. And as you exhale, maybe a little rounding of the upper back, you gaze down between your legs. Inhale, opening, and exhale, arching. Last time through, inhale, open. And this time as you exhale, you arch, you're gonna stay back and then you're gonna start to circle. Now your circles can be very small or bigger, right? Try to relax the shoulders and the neck so you can get even deeper into it. The more you let go, the deeper you're gonna find this stretch. And then take it to the other side. Sometimes we're feeling that we can't do it or you start gripping, right? That creates more tension. So think about letting go. And if it causes you any pain, you want to make your movements a little smaller or back off of it. And then coming back to the center, inhale, let your arms reach all the way up once again. And this time as you exhale, your hands come to your heart. We're going to hold the hands kind of loose here and just start to release into the wrist. So this is just a nice way to start to release. Now keep your shoulders relaxed. There's a tendency of lifting the shoulders, let them drop, and then let's do it the other way. I'm going to start to massage our palms, just like we did with our feet. So creating some heat here, rubbing your hands. And then we're going to take the thumb or a ball or something smaller. You're going to start to massage the heel of your palm. And then you're going to start to go up into the palm, the base, all the way up to each base of each finger before we go up each finger. Right, so you're also getting all these nice acupressure points in your hands. Another good one for arthritis and neuropathy on the hands. We're going to start to give a little squeeze all the way to the tips of the fingers. You start to move and squeeze it all the way up. Also getting nice acupressure points on the hands. And then we're going to do a pinchy on the webs of the fingers. So you're going to pinch, hold, and release as we move from web to web. Nice. And all the way to the thumb, the web is a little deeper on that one. Just noticing the difference between each one and then give it a little bit of a shake. All right, just feeling how one hand feels a little lighter than the other, we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So I like to start with the base and we start to move up to the base of each finger. Noticing here what feels good, what doesn't. We start to just squeeze again now all the way to the tips of the nails, fingers. All of the energy lines in the body starts on the toes and fingers. And then start to give that pinching on the web. As you move from web to web. And just noticing how this side might feel different. You might feel like sometimes there is a web that feels a little bit more sensitive than others. And this is a good exercise for also repetitive movement, things that you do all the time, right? Or you're like putting too much strain, like you're going in your garden, you start digging or chopping food for the week, right? Things like that. Or maybe just on your computer. So we're going to start working other parts of the body, focusing now a little bit more core and legs. We're going to start to squeeze that block. You're going to keep the feet same position and then you soften. And as you exhale, you squeeze, you feel that nothing's actually kind of looks like they're moving, but this is called isometric contraction, this type of contraction of the muscles. We don't see that whole movement of the fibers. And release, last one, you squeeze. And release, great job. I'm gonna take that block out of the way. I'm just gonna put it to the side. We're gonna do exactly the opposite. So now you're gonna firm your feet. So don't let your toes go up in the knees when the knees go out. So you're gonna keep the feet firmly onto the floor. You're gonna bring your hands on the outside of your legs and you're going to push your knee into your hand. You're going to resist that hand against the knee. So when you're ready, press and relax. press into it. And relax. Two more. Press. Resist. And relax. This is your last one. We're engaging the outside of the legs now. Relax. Take a short break. And we're going to start to add a little bit more of core engagement and also of the legs. So every time you're, I'm just turning it sideways so you might be able to see it better. Oof. Like can all the way some. So you're going to start to pick up your legs here. Every time you take your feet off the floor, it's going to challenge your balance. Every time it challenges your balance, you're working your core a little bit more. So you can always keep the body a little bit straight up and more contact with the floor, or you can start to pick it up higher, even staying on your tippy toes and starting to hinge. And this is definitely going to make it a little bit more core work here for four. And you can start even to tap the opposite shoulder. Three, two, and one. Nicely done. Bring yourself back up, roll your shoulders back. I'm gonna take that block and I'm gonna come into a version of Navasana boat pose with a twist. So we're gonna take the toes here. Again, if that feels too much, starting with the feet onto the floor and twisting from your shoulders, engaging your obliques and maybe a little hinge back. And then you come back to the center. And as you exhale, you go back and inhale, come back to the center. If you want more, you come into your toes as you exhale, you even hinge back, inhale up, exhale, twist, inhale up. So if you're hinging back, you're not touching the back of the chair. So you're working with your core to support you. Last one. And you come back to the center and release. Nicely done. Just take a little bit, kind of like a curl here as you pick up that foot. And you can continue with this movement and just bring that block down. Relax your shoulders. And we're going to stay with that right leg up and down. And now we're going to take that leg up, hold it, and we're going to point and flex. So now working a little bit more knee, working on your hamstring as you curl that foot and flex it back. Last one. You're going to hold it up there, point, flex, and roll your ankle. Point, flex, and roll it the other way. Now, little pulse, quadriceps, hip flexors, pulling that leg up two and one. Now we're going to drop that heel. As you inhale, lengthen your spine. Now you're going to hinge from your hips as that spine keeps nice and long, hinging over. Support onto the thigh that's bent, the other leg, the knee is soft. Never push into that leg. You're pushing in or supporting onto the other. Curling those toes, feel a little deeper. And the more you relax the head, the neck and the shoulders, the deeper you're gonna feel that stretch. So you can always add or subtract it. And as you exhale, slowly soften, bring yourself up. Maybe grab your strap. You can put it under that foot and start to open and close. So I'm just gonna turn it back to the center so you can see. You're opening and closing, starting to get more into the inner leg, also into the outer leg as you go out. I'm going to hold it out there and a little circling. Again, the knee can be bent, could be smaller. You're going to go at your own range and to the other side. Let's bring it back to the center. I'm going to crossing the ankle here. And maybe this is enough. Or if you pinch and toe your foot a little bit more to the left as you press the heel, you might start to feel it on your IT band, that fascia on the outside of your leg. Or maybe you start to incorporate that twist just to make it even deeper from the shoulder all the way down, side body, hips, and legs. And when you come out of it, we're going to cross the ankles. You can let go of that strap. You can stay with your ankles crossed or maybe the knees crossed. We're coming into eagle. So we want to feel that hugging of the legs. And when you do that, feel how your core starts to engage and lifts you up. And then we're going to take our wings here and we're going to take the right under the left and give yourselves a hug. Inhale, find a lift of your elbows. Maybe give it a little bit more hugging of those elbows and hugging of the legs or the backs of the hands or even the front can come together. Elbows can go to one side, gaze to the other, a little twist into that thoracic spine. Inhale, lift. And as you exhale, start to nest your eagle, let the hands come down. You can hold it here in front of the knee or the shin. Again, if this is too much, you can always go further down. If you want more, you start to bring that shin a little bit higher and hinging. The hinging is definitely going to get deeper into your glutes. Or you can even let that shin become more parallel to the floor as you hinge forward. So finding your figure four. So if, when you look at your legs, it looks like a number four between the legs there. That's where the name comes from. And you can take a little massage into that ball of the foot. That's the kidney point there, the line. And there's an imaginary line that traces into that arch between the bony part of your ankle and your heel. And you can trace it up into that inseam of your pants or imaginary line there, that it goes all the way up to your groin. You can also do a tapping if you prefer, knocking up just to move it up. All right, when you feel ready, we're gonna drop that leg and just doing a little movement with the hips here, legs. So we did a lot of work onto the front. We start to work onto the hamstrings and the back. But now we're gonna stretch these muscles. These are your hip flexors, your quadriceps. So we're gonna turn to the side and come into what we call a variation of a crescent line. So the important thing here is that front heel is not beyond, the knee is not beyond the toes or the heel. So that heel is kind of aligned with the knee or even a little further out to the front. You're gonna hold onto the back of the chair for support. Now, again, you can just play here by drawing the navel in, dropping that tail and lengthening the spine. This is what's gonna give you that stretch, right? So you can stay here and not even put a lot of pressure onto the knee, or even taking a block under your knee. Now remember, the block has three heights. You can always change depending on the height. This chair is a little big for me, so I really feel that I need a little bit more support. And even so, that if you feel that you needed a block under that front foot, right, you can always do that as well. So that would be some levels to adjust here. You can stay seated on your chair, or if you want to deepen that intensity on the strengthening, you come off and you playing with that tuck. Maybe there's a little dropping up and down. So the more you have the shoulders, the hips, and the knees aligned, the deeper you're going to feel that stretch. Two and one. Maybe hold it down into your crescent lunge, allowing that right arm to reach up and over. Little pulling of the navel, dropping of the tail to get deeper, and then slowly bring yourself down. Nicely done. And just kind of do a little windshield wipe of your knees. Open up into your goddess squat or horse stance with the toes and knees pointing in the same direction. So don't let the knees flop in, firm them out. Inhale, finding that full goddess pose. We're gonna dance over to the right. Inhale, center. And exhale to the left. Let's come back to the center again, and let's work exactly on the other side. So shimmy the feet. I'm just going to turn sideways so you can see a little bit better, and picking up that left leg up and down. Could be small, could be big, right? Your choice. Hold it up, point and flex. Start to curl. Flexing, getting into the hamstrings and getting the quadriceps, the knee joints, the ankles. This is your last one. We're going to hold it out there. Point, flex, and roll your ankle. Point, flex, and roll it the other way. A little pulse for four and three. Two, quadriceps work. One, we're going to drop that heel. Inhale, lengthen your spine. It's the hinging of the hips. The knee is soft. The support is on that bent leg. The more you push your hips back, the more you press that heel, the more you curl your toes, all these things will add to the stretch on the back of your legs, relaxing the shoulders, the neck, gaze down. And when you feel ready, slowly bring yourself up, soften that knee, grab your strap, and perhaps you bring it under your foot for a little inner leg, outer leg stretch here. Now again, the knee can be bent. The leg can be straight. Your range of motion can be small or it can be big, right? Your choice. When you take it out, just circle it. Try to keep the shoulders relaxed. There's a tendency of engaging those shoulders more than they need. And when you come back to the center, hold it here and start to slightly twist and cross. So getting more into the outside. Press into the heel, turn the toes. Inhale, lengthen your spine as you exhale. Gently revolve that shoulder slightly back. Can we do that again? Inhale, lift. And exhale, deepening that twist. Nicely done. Taking that ankle down or crossing the knees. You're going to find the version of eagle that works for you here. Feel your knees hugging in, lifting up the core. Open your majestic eagle wings here, and then you're going to take your left under the right. Give yourselves a hug. Inhale, let your elbows lift. You can stay with that self-hug or the back of the hands or even the front. You can take that peek over the shoulders. Inhale, lift. And as you exhale, nesting your eagle, elbows come in, hands come in front. Maybe you hinge forward. Maybe you start to find that version of figure four. Find a version that works for you. This side might feel very different than the other, right? So you move with caution. You can move. You can give that little self-massage if you like. Again, there's no right or wrong. Make sure that you're starting to feel that really nice stretch onto your glutes, as long as you're not feeling pain on the knees or the hips, right? And slowly come out of it, doing a little windshield wiping. And eventually we're going to turn to the right. So firming into that right foot, all those movements that we did on the left. And again, you can stay on your chair and playing with that kind of like dipping, navel pulling in, chest lifting, right? You're stretching these muscles. They're connected with your spine, passes in front of your hips, connecting with that, the bone and your legs. So you can feel that lift. So when you lengthen, that's when you get to stretch. Hold. Now you can stay here, and then maybe you start to draw up and down, or stay on your chair and doing that tucking. Two and one, hold it down, engage the core, and now maybe you reach that arm up and over. Great job. Let's come down. Nicely done. So as we're working a little bit more with the side body, we're going to start to do a little bit of warriors on the chair. So you can take your right foot out to the side and open your left leg to the side here. So we're going to inhale and take our arms along as warrior two here. So if this feels too much, you can make your stance a little shorter, right? And not put too much intensity into the legs moving away from each other. Open the heart nice and long. You can even gaze over your front fingertips. Those are the front, the knee and toes are pointing in the same direction. So try not to let the knee buckle in. And then from here, we're coming into extended side angle. Left hand comes to the chair and your right arm reaches up and over. And just like we did in the beginning, that we're looking and trying to look to that beautiful bird up in the sky, right? This is an open twist. The back of the hand can also stay onto your back and feel that opening. Now we're going to come back into a warrior two. You can stay seated on your chair or even come off your chair. And once again, float into your extended side angle and then the chair and opening. Inhaling, warrior two, and exhale, returning to your chair if you're not there yet. And reverse, let's try to take it to the other side. Firming your feet, engaging your core, and start to find what works here for you. So do you want to stay on your chair? You want to make it less intense if you're not coming up, and just kind of really start to connect. The right hand is going to come to the chair, and as you inhale, your left arm starts to reach up and over, feeling the opening through the side body engagement here. And then release, inhale, come back into your warrior two. Now again, you can place staying seated or starting to find that flow as you come up off your chair. Release, inhale, back into your warrior two. And when you feel ready, slowly returning. And return back as you find your seat, you find your movement, and we're gonna come back again. So heel-toeing your feet closer together. And we're coming into a squat or chair pose on the chair. So I have a block between my knees, so my knees won't wobble in or out. So trying to keep them firm. So we're practicing something that we do every day. This is part of like functional training, things that you do every day, getting out of a chair, getting out of your bed, out of a couch, right? These are squat movements. So we're just training to do them more efficiently and stronger. So keeping the hand on the chair, you're going to come up and then return back down. If you have it like a brace in your knees that feels uncomfortable, that you prefer to stay standing behind your chair and holding on the chair, you can always do that. If you want more, you can start to cross your arms. And if you want more, you can even reach your hand forward. And as we exhale, we twist. As we reach one hand back and inhale, come back. And exhale, we twist. Inhale. And exhale, we twist. Or just staying with the hands on the chair and working with your own breathing, your own pace. Inhale. Come all the way up this time. Take that block from between your legs. I'm going to find the back of the chair for a down dog on the chair. Now, down dog on the chair is a pose that you can do anywhere, right? Because it's something that, as long as you have a support for your hands, so you can do this when you wake up, on your, put your hands against your bed or on your kitchen counter or on your desk. Soften your knees and let your tailbone go up. And then maybe you start to pedal, bending one knee and then the other, and then even looking under one armpit and then the other. Notice how the stretch transfers from the arms, side body, down the spine, the hips, the legs, all the way down to your feet. And you can do this again, any place, with any intensity. If it feels too much to have the arms extended, you can always fold your arms like genie arms and do a shorter version or drop the head even less. And as you exhale, slowly walk yourself back up to your chair. So we're just going to stay up here and just working with a version of half or crescent moon or half moon. Let's do the version that we can stay closer to the chair or next to a wall. And your hands are going to be about, you know, hip height, a little bit lower. So you're not taking it too high up. So just keeping that hand lower. Soften your knees here, and we're going to press into that big toe mound of the feet. And at the same time, feeling like your outer pockets are pushing out. So the leg starts to feel engaged, the core starts to drop. And as you inhale, you're going to take your left arm up and over, like you're going to touch that wall. It doesn't have to, but that's the direction it's going. And the bottom hand can push against, so your hip starts to move over to the left. And you start to create your crescent moon here. Push. And maybe you even look up and under if you want to play with the angle and increasing or decreasing the intensity. And then slowly bring yourself back up. Nice. Let's try this on the other side. So you turn it around, or maybe you find another side, right? Or you turn against to the wall or move it around. Again, firm through your feet. You have a little bit of space, so you can use that hand to push, right? And now inhale, you reach. And as you exhale, you start to push. Firm through the feet, hips go wide, maybe even looking under. How does this side compare with the other, right? And then you slowly bring yourself back again. Now I'm going to show you a second version, and if that one requires a little bit more balance. So again, every time you start to challenge your balance, right, you work a little bit more of a core. And just by transferring the weight from one side to the other, it becomes a weight-bearing exercise. So you soften the knee and your toes just go very light to the side. And maybe this is where you stay. You can add the arm up. Maybe that foot will go slightly behind. Maybe that foot will even cross. You're in the toes and ball of the foot. And then slowly release. Different variations of the pose that you can do. Some of you have been practicing for a while, and maybe you're trying to find a little bit more of a challenge. So you can always add that. So again, you can just come to your toes and just soften the knee. So don't lock that standing leg. The knee is soft. Maybe the foot will start to go a little further back. It maybe even crosses. Again, that will be a deeper twist, right? And a deeper balance. Release and control it back down. Nicely done. Let's find our chair to close our practice. As you find your seat, maybe taking those blocks under your feet, allowing the hands to rest on your lap once again, and just moving all the way back. Take a nice deep breath in and a big sigh. Allow your eyes to close. Allowing your body to soften from the top of the head down to the toes. Relaxing the muscles in the face, the corners of the eyes, inner ears rolling inwards and down. Relaxing the cheeks, the jaw. Allow the tongue to float in your mouth. Feel the release down the back of the throat to the shoulders, the elbows, and fingertips soften. And the heart is light. The belly is soft. And your hips feeling heavy, supported by the chair. Continue to relax down the knees, the heels, the toes. You're happy where you are, stay where you are. You're in the comfort and safety of your home. But if you feel like moving, start to wiggle the fingers and the toes as you start to add the wrists and the ankles. Take your time. And bringing your palms together in front of your heart. And we're finishing this week with Kapata Mudra, the Dove Mudra. The nonviolence, ahimsa. You're going to keep the fingertips together and you're going to spread your knuckles apart like you're holding this little secret, special little gift in front of your heart. And this mudra cultivates peace and unconditional love. Non-harming to yourself and to the others. Non-harming to the body and the mind. As you feel your body filled with peace and unconditional love, and carrying it with you, even brighter, that light that you brought in. Taking your thumbs to your forehead, and together we bow namaste. The light in me bows to the light in you. Thank you so much for letting me guide you today. If you have any questions, doubts, feedback, please let me know. Otherwise, have a great weekend. Be well. If you have any questions, I'll stay a little bit longer.